Welcome to our Good News program. We're so thankful that you've tuned in. I know that you are enjoying these lessons because these are the most important lessons we have ever given out. And we are expecting 100-fold. And we are teaching you Prescription for Revival if you haven't been following along with us. But we are praying for every person because God's Word teaches us that we cannot be right with God without being born again by the Spirit of God. So this Prescription for Revival is let a few Christians get thoroughly right with God. If this is not done, the rest will come to nothing. And this is why we're showing you the truths about our enemy, what Satan is doing, trying to deceive the very elect. And if you have turned from your Savior, your Redeemer, if you have truly been born again, you cannot let Satan deceive you by his deception if you know the Word of God. You have to know these truths. That's why we're giving them to you. You have to live. What is the highest and holiest thing under heaven? What is the highest and holiest thing under heaven? I want to know, can you answer that with a true, true word? The highest and holiest calling under heaven is to know Christ, to have your sins forgiven, and to know that you're ready for heaven, because Christ could come at any moment. So the thing that we are wanting to teach you today and is about Christ and what he has done for us and our enemy Satan. Listen at this, Matthew 25 verse 38 through 41. The field is the world, the good seed of the children of the kingdom, but the tares are the children of the wicked one. The enemy that sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of this world, and the reapers are the angels. As therefore the tares are gathered and burned in the fire, so shall it be at the end of this world. The Son of Man shall send forth his angels, and they shall gather out of his kingdom all things that offend and them which do iniquity. If you have turned from the Lord, make sure that you were not just a professing Christian. Because this is what's going to happen to you. And shall cast them into a furnace of fire. There shall be wailing and gnashing of teeth. Then shall the righteous shine as the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Who hath ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit saith. The Antichrist today is desperately striving for complete dominion. He is to marshal the world's armies in the Holy Land in Israel and prepare for Armageddon. This time is close. Then Matthew chapter 25, verse 41. Then shall he say unto them on the left hand, Depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. I want you, everyone right now, that is truly a child of God, to turn to him from any sin in your life. Because if I have sin in my life, the Lord will not hear me. And to begin to to follow this prescription for revival. If you've never been born again, today you can receive the Lord Jesus Christ as Savior. It is as simple as John 3:16. For God so loved you, put your name there, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. By his own blood, by Christ's own blood, he entered in once into the holy place. As the Son of Man, he had to go to heaven with his own blood. We're going to learn about his blood this week or next week. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me, but through the precious blood of Christ. Will it be eternally? Where will you live? Will it be eternally in the presence of our Savior? With this beautiful place that he's prepared for us, that eye hath not seen nor ear heard the glories he has for us. In my Father's house are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you. I will come again and receive you unto myself. That is going to be the rapture taking place. We're going to meet him in the clouds. I go to prepare a place for you. I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And now, which one do you choose? This beautiful place, the streets are pure gold, the city's pure gold. A body, a place of light. Or will you choose this suffering under eternal damnation forever and ever? In the parables, the Lord Jesus Christ surely showed the distinct difference between heaven and hell. You will either belong to one or the other as a result of your own choosing. You just read in Matthew 25:41. It was prepared for the devil and his angels and not for you. You choose this today because the next moment you may not be here. You must choose this right now because this is the greatest need in the world, because the Bible verse, this is a heavenly divine message. There's no controversy. This is going to happen. 2 Corinthians 13:8. For we can do nothing against the truth, but for the truth. We can do nothing. This is going to happen. There is nothing that God has written here that's not going to happen. Proverbs 21:30. There is no wisdom, nor understanding, nor counsel against this truth. This is the way, the truth, and the life. This is divine revelation. This is inspired word of God. This is the living word. You must read it every day. And I don't tell you because many people don't study the Word of God. You cannot go to church and learn how to live this book. You have to study it daily. And this is John 17:3. I am the way, the truth, and the life, and this is life eternal. The way, the truth, and the life, no man cometh to the Father but by this one. This is life eternal, that ye may know me, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. Let's pray. Oh, our gracious and dear Heavenly Father, my heart is so broken. I have such a burden for these little children out here everywhere. For every person that's listening, adults that don't even know these truths. Every person after they become a child of God is a teacher of the gospel, the good news. I'm praying for every person that's listening today to get on your knees right now and pray for every child to be brought out of darkness into light, out of the power of Satan under thee. And as we come to our Heavenly Father, His throne of grace, we can call Him Father as soon as we receive this gift. He becomes our Heavenly Father the moment we believe. The moment we are cleansed from the precious blood, with the precious blood of Christ, all sins forgiven. Every person on this earth, our armed forces, our nation, our leaders, every person is the same in God's sight. In Adam all die, in Christ all live. And this beautiful place He has prepared for us when we reach the speed of light, 186,241 miles per second. We have a body of light. We're living in light. There's no darkness where Christ is. His light puts out all darkness. Oh, I'm begging every person today to try this prescription for revival. It's worth everything. The whole world is ours when we receive Christ. Everything belongs to Him. And these things that we have are going to be burned up. Oh, we're asking. Just call upon Him right now. If you just know John 3:16, use that. And believe that He died on that cross for you. And every person is the same in His sight. And we all need this right now. Bring every person out of darkness into light, out of the power of Satan under thee. In Christ's name we pray, amen. So we're seeing this wonderful gift that God has given to us as true believers, the Word of God, the Word of God. You see, if you know the Word, His blood, this is so amazing. His crucifixion atones our sins. His resurrection eradicates from sin. Eradicates. He never remembers them no more. Psalm 12:6, the words of the Lord are pure words, as silver tried in the furnace of the earth, purified seven times. That's how pure these words are. Psalm 119:89. Forever, O Lord, Thy word is settled in heaven. This is a divine heavenly calling. That's why we have to go to the throne of grace in heaven. There's no earthly worship today, only in the body of believers, and Christ is the head of that body. This is the only way you can get to heaven. Psalm 119:127, therefore, I love Thy commandments above gold, yea, above fine gold. Psalm 119:103, how sweet are Thy words unto my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth. Job 23:12, Job's great wisdom, I have esteemed the words of God's mouth more than my necessary food. Oh, I pray that you will get on this, in this book, in the book of John, and read the book of John. You have to do that as a child of God. This is the first thing. Jesus is the Word, the living Word. Jesus is the way. The Word, what is the Word? A manifestation and revelation of a thought from one mind to another mind. The words are made up of letters. John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word, always been, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In the beginning was Jesus, and Jesus was with God, and Jesus was God. Jesus is the manifestation and revelation of the mind of God to the mind of man. Why does it tell us to have the mind of God? He's every letter, the first letter of the Greek. I am Alpha. I am Omega, the last letter. He is the whole alphabet. Christ is perfect. Christ is the red heifer. Numbers 19, the red heifer, without spot, without blemish. Let God form your plans about everything in your mind and heart, and let him execute them. Our mind, the Word of God, is to be hid in our hearts, that we will not sin against God. Our heart, when you give your heart to Christ today, and I know many of you have, your heart is your intellect, your emotions, and your will. This is a heavenly divine message. The first and greatest revelation is that God is love. Oh, can you imagine what this love is? This is a commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. By this shall all men know you are my disciples, if you have love one for another. I want you just to read this one word. Love your enemies. You see, you can hate another person and have eternal life dwelling in you. When God created the heavens and the earth in the beginning, the earth was a ball of light, the revealing of the very nature of God, for God is light. The attributes of God are divine perfection. Light, love, and life are always connected in scriptures. The Lord Jesus Christ is both light and truth. He is God's light and God's truth. Is there anything else in this world for anyone? What is the highest and holiest calling? The highest and holiest calling is to know Christ. Do you know that this is the manifestation of His love for you today? Loving the way He loves us is the greatest gift that we have. Now we get back to Romans. I'm going to try, if I can, to get some of this in, because I want every person that is living this prescription for revival, that is, we must be sure of our salvation. We must be a forgiving person to those around us, 70 times 7, never holding a grudge against anyone. It means we're not to grieve God's. How could we grieve Him because of bitterness, wrath, anger, clamor, evil speaking, or malice? But to be ye kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving and forgiving and forgiving again, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven us. Through Adam, sin and death. Romans 5:12. Now, we must see how Romans has the greatest truths concerning our salvation, because he says the wages of sin is death. That's through Adam. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. So in Romans 5, verse 12, whereby as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin. And so death passed upon all men, for all have sinned. We're all the same in God's sight. Never look at yourself and thinking that you are better than another person. That is pride, and God hates pride. Then he says in 5:18, I want you to listen at this. You're either in Adam or in Christ. Therefore, as by one offense of one judgment came upon all men to condemnation and death. That's why you have to have the Holy Spirit. Unless you're born again, you have a death chamber and you are going to an eternal hell. By Adam's trespass, condemnation and death. Through Christ, righteousness and life. Justification by Christ's righteous act of death for us. Romans 3:24. These are so amazing when you see the great truth about Christ. It's all about Him. Remember, there's no organizations and no religion. No religions. Being justified freely by His grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. Now remember, that's Romans 23. I know some of you write and talk too fast and you can't get the scriptures. You have to have these scriptures. Romans 5:1. Being justified by faith, we have peace with God. Being justified by faith, we have peace with God. What does justification mean? I've been declared righteous by God. That's what it means. And then see, before you were saved, your righteousness were as filthy rags. But now you have righteousness, and this is His perfect will. And then Romans 5:9. All the blessings of these lessons. Listen at this. Much more than being now justified by His blood, we shall be saved from wrath through Him. Now get these Bible verses. Romans 5:12, Romans 5:18, Romans 3:24, Romans 5:1, Romans 5:9, justified by His blood. But look at Romans 5:18, the last part of this. Even so, by the righteousness of the one free gift. This is all free. Heaven is all free. You don't work for salvation. You can't do anything for salvation because God declared us righteous by His death. Even so, by the righteousness of one, Jesus Christ, the free gift came upon all men unto justification of life. Justification of life. And then Acts 13:39, Paul taught about Christ. All the disciples taught about Christ. This book of Hebrews that we've been studying, it's to the Hebrew people because God only gave religion to one nation, and that was Israel, and that ended at the cross. And he says in Acts 13:39, justified from all things. From all things. We reign in this earth as a king. We are His. And if you know this book, you live the abundant life. Romans 6:1-11. We died with Christ, our baptism being witness, and are to reckon ourselves dead unto sin and alive unto God in Christ Jesus. I know that I may not have time to do all of these today, but I want you to listen at this divine, heavenly, divine message. We died to sin, Romans 6:2. Romans 6:3, we were baptized into His death. Romans 6:4, we were buried with Him through baptism into death. Remember, the blood of Jesus Christ. Baptism cannot do one thing. It just shows that you're being identified with the death, burial, and resurrection of Christ. 6:5, Romans 6:5. we became united with him in the likeness of his death. Romans 6:6, our old man was crucified with him. Romans 6:7, he that hath died is justified from sin. Romans 6:8, we died with Christ. Romans 6:11, reckon yourselves dead unto sin, but alive unto God in Christ Jesus. Romans 6:13, present yourselves unto God as alive from the dead, by counting the old life to be dead, and by yielding the new life to God. In Colossians 3:3, we have to know this lesson, because this is the most important lesson you'll ever hear. Colossians 3:3, here's what he says. If you then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth at the right hand of God. Set your affections on things above, not on things of the world. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear in those clouds, then shall ye also appear with him in glory. Galatians 2:20. I am crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live. I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. Yielding your life, we are in the risen Christ, and we share his death. Our relationship to sin is broken forever. We walk in newness of life, and have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. You bring wonder, bring wonder.